calculate the current streak in a habit tracker? Oh, I love this question and this idea from Amreen. Sorry, I don't know how to pronounce that. He's building a habit tracker, tracking his habits over 30 days and looking for the current streak. How many days in a row has he done some particular item? What a great idea this is. So here's how I'm going to build this. The numbers 1 through 30 going across the top. Things I want to do going down the left-hand side. If I did something that day, I put a 1. If I didn't do it that day, I put a 0. We want to figure out here at the end, how many 1s in a row do we have? The formula I'm going to use to find the last 1 is the XMATCH formula. I'm looking for a 1. Where am I looking? I'm looking in these 30 cells right here. I want to lock down the column, so I'm going to press F4 3 times. 1, 2, 3 times. And I want an exact match, so a 0. Ah, this is really cool. XLOOKUP and XMATCH have the ability to search last to first to find the last item in the list, which is great. So the last one occurred on the 25th. I'll take that formula and we'll put it in here. This time we're looking for a 0. Where is the last 0? All right, so, yep, good. Now this one, perform a seminar or a webinar. Today's Sunday, I'm not doing one today. So, you know, there is currently no streak. So we're gonna handle that first. Equal, if the last 0 is greater than the last 1, then no streak, try today. A little bit of motivation there, right? And if that's not true, that means that we're currently in a streak, and that streak is going to be where is the last 1 minus where is the last 0. And so it says that our current streak here for the Magic Mind energy drink is a 6-day streak. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If I do it again tomorrow, it'll grow to 7. And then if I don't do it on Tuesday, then it resets the streak like that. Publish a video. I'm currently on a 1-day streak, assuming that this video gets published today. Perform a seminar or a webinar, currently not in a streak, but let's say that I think I have one scheduled on Wednesday, right? So then I'll be on a 1-day streak like that. I'm going to point out that this isn't the first time I've dealt with streaks. All the way back in episode 735, it was how to calculate the longest win streak. And in that particular case, it was something like if I had put together a streak like this and then missed a day and then a short streak like that, it would be able to find that longest winning streak. So, you know, that's not what we're doing today. That's already been addressed here. Go back to episode 735. I'll put an I in the top right-hand corner to go back to that. Now, Amreen said that he wants to have check boxes, right? Zeros and ones are much easier to deal with, but we can make it look like it's check boxes, right? So we essentially have 3 states here, a 0, a 1, and nothing at all for the days that are in the future. Right, so my goal is to make it look like this. How do I find those check boxes? I put the numbers 1 to 255 down the left-hand column, and then equals CHAR of that cell in webdings, wingdings, wingdings 2, wingdings 3, and calibre. Once I find the checkbox I want to use, I'm going to use this one. We know that Q is unchecked, R is checked. All right, so, you know, I can never remember that. I end up building that little worksheet. In fact, you know, here, I built that worksheet today just because I can never remember where they are or which one it is. And sure, you might be using emoticons or something to make it easier. All right, so we select all 30 cells, all of the habits we want to track. So we'll press Control 1. We'll go into the custom number format. There's 4 zones here. The first zone is positive, then negative, then 0, then text. Each zone is separated by a semicolon. Let's see, I want to put in R for the positive numbers, so R. For negative numbers, that should never happen, so nothing there, 2 semicolons in a row. And then Q for 0, and then for text, nothing. All right, so we have, that should give us a series of R's and Q's, and that's working. Sometimes the letter that you type in there, you need to put a slash R before it, and here they actually did that for me. All right, so for positive numbers is green, and for negative numbers in square brackets, red. That. Yep. All right, good. So red Q's and green R's. We're almost home. Just come here and change the font from Calibri to Wingdings 2. And now we get our little checkboxes. And tomorrow, if I put a 1 in there, I get a new checkbox. If I put a 0 in there, we get the X, right? So it looks like we want it to look. And hopefully that's good. I suppose you could hide these two columns or even improve that formula over there in AH to embed these, you know, whichever you want to do. This though should get you going. All right, so what a great motivation tool here in Excel. Great idea from Amreen. Hopefully these steps, while convoluted, will get you there. And Amreen, look down in the YouTube comments. Give it about a day. There'll be better ways to do this. You can use one. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.